y'all doing? I'm good. There was a huge earthquake last night in Chiapas that is 700 miles from me, like a 16-hour drive, and yet I felt it. I was sitting here on my computer, and things started moving, and I was like, I actually called on Archangel Michael first, because I was like, am I going crazy? What is this right now? And I didn't know if anything was moving until I saw my keys. It wasn't like a violent shaking, but I saw my keys in the door swaying back and forth, and I was like, the earth is moving. The earth is moving underneath me. And then I ended up, you know, finding out that there was a 8-point-something magnitude earthquake in Chiapas. But from what I hear, it was, I think, in the water or closer to the coast. So hopefully, I haven't checked anything this morning. That was at like 1 o'clock in the morning last night. But I am okay. Thank you for joining. Say hello. Hello, Angelique and Angelica. Lucas, Maya. Who else? Good morning, good morning. So yes, I am good. I did feel the earthquake. But really, guys, man, oh man, we are dealing with things we have never seen before all within a couple weeks. Like, we have earthquakes. We have fire in California. We have unprecedented hurricane winds in the Caribbean, in Florida. And we have crazy water everywhere. Flooding. Water. So Earth is, it's like she has a fever. When we have a fever, that's our body's way of fighting it off. Our body heats up so hot so it can kill all the bacteria. It can kill the infection. So she is heating up. She's got chills. You know how you shake with the chills as the earthquake. Of course, the fever burning everything out. Hot sweats. How many times you sitting there sweating because you got that fever? Flooding everything. So yeah, and then the wind. Crazy, crazy winds. She's sneezing. But what we do know is that this has all been talked about. Every ancient civilization in the Bible, this has all been told to us, that a time would come where Earth's balance would be completely off and we would see things that we were not expecting to see, and that the people would go crazy, and then we'd be cool again. So it's kind of like, man, I don't know how to explain it the way I feel it, but what are you guys thinking? How are you guys feeling? Thank you on Instagram. Good morning. I was worried about you. I appreciate that. I'm good. I'm good. See, Amara, beautiful. She said, peace. Love your explanation. Glad you're safe. Thank you, Dustin. I am. Maya, I am. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Carmen, hello. Erica, good morning. Hello, everyone. So, yes, let's do the Oath of Manifestation. As Christ consciousness comes back to the human realm, comes back to our consciousness, and it's kind of, so when I say Christ consciousness, think of it like going from your iPhone 5 to an iPhone 7S operating system. May have the same phone, look the same, you chose the same colors, you set up the front, you know, all of your apps and your icons to be exactly the same as your iPhone 5, but now you have this new operating system that, you know, your photos kind of move when, you know, they didn't used to move before, or, you know, now you can use your eye to, you know, log in, or your fingerprint to log in when you couldn't do that before. And that's what we're getting as well. But it's, you know, it's a shakeup. It's like a crash for that, like the computer crashes to the point where you can't use it, or things go haywire, and then you're like, fine, let me upgrade the phone. So that's really, truly an example of what we're going through now. Everything is just going haywire, haywire, haywire. But hey, what if these crazy-ass, natural, horrendous disasters is what it will take to get humans to live on one accord? What if it's that, this craziness that needs to take place for people to wake up and be like, yo, I'm no different than that person over there because I too lost everything. Or what if it's, you know, I lost everything and I've been an asshole to this whole race of people, but now I see that they too are human. Because they didn't budge when it was time to help me. So, you know, there are all these different things we never know But I am one of those people that always sees, I see things differently. And they're not always the popular opinion. They're not always the way that, you know, people feel makes sense or whatnot. But I liken it to, and I hate it. Open manifestation, guys. Let's read the top part that I do not have memorized. The oath of manifestation. This oath is done every day with a partner, spoken out loud with tremendous feeling and emphasis. It can be said many times throughout the day. It can be recorded and listened to on your smartphone. So again, we are reprogramming the subconscious mind, because I can guarantee you, if you're online, if you're watching television, you are being programmed with fear, with anxiety. You are dealing with, well, what if an earthquake comes here? What if the hurricane gets my friends? What if this, what if that? And so it's like, let's take this time to choose what we're going to think for this 10 minutes. Let's choose what we're going to think instead of allowing our thoughts and our speech to go away with us. So I accept and receive unexpected good, unexpected money, unexpected love, unexpected kindness, unexpected generosity, unexpected offers, unexpected prosperity coming in unexpected ways from unexpected places in my life and the lives of others. I am constantly guided and I am boldly empowered to receive the lavish abundance of the universe. I accept the principle that abundance and prosperity have already been given to me. It's my acceptance that makes it real and opens the space for manifestation to rush in. I open wide the doors of my consciousness to receive and to give. It is done now. Through this oath of manifestation, all things are possible. I declare absolutely. I live in a friendly universe that is always providing for me. I feel it powerfully happening now. I open to receive more abundance and to give more abundance than I have ever experienced before. I can afford anything I desire. In fact, I am so prosperous, I need never worry again. I am grateful. I am grateful for all that I already have, and I am grateful for all that I am ready to give. I keep myself lifted in high consciousness. No matter what the appearances are, God is all there is, and I let the God times roll, and so it is. Ache and amen, highest will for all be done again and again and again and again. And even with all these natural disasters and the fear that is just plaguing the world right now, no matter what the appearances are, God is all there is. No matter what the appearances are, God is all there is. No matter what the appearances are, God is all there is. We are good. We are covered. We got here with nothing. We will leave here with nothing. If we spend a couple, you know, couple days, couple years, couple whatever with nothing, we will be okay. So as we get these upgrades as human beings, as we begin to change the way our minds have worked for generations and generations and generations, what are you doing to prepare? What are you doing to prepare? You cannot run a new operating system on an old way of life. You cannot run a new thought process on old habits. So what are you doing now to prepare? That's where I come in. So yes, I am launching. I just launched last night. Check my website. I did my whole website by myself. Like, by myself. Nobody has helped me. And I'm so proud of it. If you guys could go take a look, I'd be awesomely grateful. It's www.amora.me. That's it. Simple. And you can go up to the top, and I have a bunch of drop-down menus that will take you different places. But I am launching the Clear and Guard Your Energy online clearing series. So Mondays at 8 p.m. and then Wednesdays at 3:30 p.m., both Central Standard Time, we will gather online and do an energy clearing, do a grounding, doing things to help you fortify your energy field. Who knows what the hell is going to happen? Honestly, I don't. I just know I don't have fear about it. Because if anything, just like, I'm ready to go. Like, if it has to happen, it has to happen. Like, and then I'm also working on a fear of death series. Let me know if anybody has a fear of death. I totally don't. I'm getting so off topic, but I read an Instagram it was like a meme yesterday or the day before yesterday that said, the reason you wake up when you die in your dreams is because the brain has no idea or what to do with it. So I've died in my dreams before, and I remember, and I've had no issues with it. I drowned one time, completely drowned, and then I turned into a mermaid. And then another time I fell and I died. And then I just went back to the spirit realm. And I didn't have a body. I was just like an angel. But yes. So has anybody else died in their dreams and actually like didn't wake up and just carried on? But yeah. But anyway, that I got off topic. But so that's coming in the future, Fear of Death series, where we're working through that we are divine beings of light. Like, there is nothing to fear. The Bible, if you believe in Christianity, the Bible tells you there's nothing to fear. If you believe, if you're Muslim, the Quran tells you there's nothing to fear. If you're reading the Emerald Tablets, they tell you there's nothing to fear. But we still fear death. We still fear. Okay, so, and then there's the Clear and Guard Your Energy series. Like I said, Monday, 8 p.m., Wednesdays, 3:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, we will gather online, and I'll do some energy clearing. I will also be praying for these people. So check out the registration on my website, www.amora/clearandguard. I'm getting fancy with my addresses and everything, too. Joanna, hello, my love. Yes, I am. I am about 700 miles away from the earthquake. I am 700 miles away from the earthquake. I felt it. My things were kind of like swaying. You know, living in California, we understand what an earthquake is. So I knew immediately that it was, well, I'm not going to say immediately. At first I was like, Archangel Michael, is there something that I need? Can you clear this place? And then I was like, oh wait, things are still moving. And then I saw my keys and I was like, oh yeah, this is an earthquake. But yeah, 700 miles away, it's like a 16-hour drive, and I still felt it. Things were still, the whole city was moving. So that's crazy. But just talking about, you know, Earth, she's cleansing herself. We always talk about how Earth needs healing. Earth, she good. We the ones need the healing. Earth is good. She gonna handle on her own. She's powerful. She's more powerful than all of us. We need her. Of course she needs us too. We do our part. We aren't, you know, throwing stuff on the ground. We aren't, you know, buying chemical stuff, you know, whatever. But at the same time, Earth gonna do what Earth gonna do. She's built that way. You cannot destroy her. She will destroy you before anything. So what are you doing to raise your vibration to hit her when she's like, all right, I'm done. The fever is gone. The flooding is over. Now, who's left? Who's ready to work with me? That's how I feel. So, although, you know, things are happening, we are not turning a blind eye to it. All I can do is focus on raising my vibration. Does that make sense? And you are welcome to join me. So, again, Mondays, 8 p.m., Wednesdays, 3:30 p.m., Clear and Guard Your Energy online clearing. So we'll be gathering together. I will be doing clearings for you guys through the internet. Energy is not bound by time or space. The same way you can answer the phone and have a phone call with someone and you're in a shitty ass mood because they really said some horrible stuff, we can flip that around and I can do the same thing. It's the energy, it's the emotion, it's the vibration that that person is giving off. And so yeah, take advantage of it. The pricing is $11 per session or $26 for 3 sessions. And so I have it set up for the month of September right now. You can drop down, choose which one it is that you would like to join or which ones you would like to join. Fill out the registration and I will send you the information to log in. So connection, connection, connection. That is what is needed now. Connection to the earth, connection to each other. Because we don't know what's going on. All we know is that in the end, it's going to be okay. And that's on a macrocosm and a microcosm scale. In life, you could, again, you may have lost everything. You may not know if you're going to have a job tomorrow. But real talk, in a year, you'll be fine, right? Yeah. In 5 years, you won't even remember. So that's a microcosm scale. That's on our little human timeline. on a larger timeline, even if all of the planet was extinct, we're gonna be okay. There's a larger picture. And so we just have to get in connection with that picture. We have to get grounded with that picture so we're not all, what if this happens? What if this happens? Oh no, what if this happens? And I'm guilty of it too. I'm not saying I'm beyond it. I have tools though. I have ways to get through it and realize and check myself. Like, Amora, you're worrying again. You're worried about your debt. You're worried about your finances. You're worried about the darkness. Like, and it's like, but no, I'm covered. I've never been dead. I mean, not dead. I've never been harmed to the point of not being able to come back. So I assume it'll just continue until I die. And I'm not afraid of that either. So it's like, let's just have fun and help people that are not able to have fun because of one reason or another. All right. How y'all doing? Let's do the Oath of Manifestation again. For those who are here, we have some folks. Erica, Bruce, earthquakes are intense. Yes. Oh, the earthquakes. All right, so the Oath of Manifestation, we got new folks. So this is something we do every morning, 9 a.m., Monday through Friday. The Oath of Manifestation is so that we can put out good energy about what it is that we want to manifest and take back a part of our day and choose what it is that we want to speak about. Choose what it is that we want to think, because our subconscious mind is what runs this shit. And right now our subconscious mind is out of control unless you have a practice, a intentional practice that is like, yo, I'm gonna, no, subconscious mind, come back here, ego, you tripping, wait, I catch you, I see you, gotta work with you, let's figure this out. This is to help. The Oath of Manifestation. I accept and receive unexpected good, unexpected money, unexpected love, unexpected kindness, unexpected generosity, unexpected offers, unexpected prosperity coming in unexpected ways from unexpected places in my life and the lives of others. I am constantly guided. I am boldly empowered to receive the lavish abundance of this universe. I accept the principle that abundance and prosperity have already been given to me. It's my acceptance that makes it real and opens the space for manifestation to rush in. I open wide the doors of my consciousness to receive and to give. It is done now. Through this Oath of Manifestation, all things are possible. I declare absolutely that I live in a friendly universe that is always providing for me. I feel it powerfully happening now. I open to receive more abundance and to give more abundance than I have ever experienced before. I can afford anything I desire. In fact, I am so prosperous, I need never worry again. I am grateful for all that I already have, and I am grateful for all that I am ready to give. I keep myself lifted in high consciousness. No matter what the appearances are, God is all there is. And I let the God times roll. And so it is, Ache and Amen. Highest will for all be done again and again and again and again. No matter what the appearances are, God is all there is. Fuck what you heard. Sorry about my language. I just get so like all this. And I have to psych myself out too, because people hurting hurts. I'm an empath. Like I'm not going to say I hate the term empath. I'm not, whatever. But I feel other people's pain. I cried during the last airbender two nights ago. Dude. So, yes. I love you guys. I love you guys. I love you guys. Nikala. I got it right. Nikala, you're so welcome. She said, thank you, thank you. Who else is there? I let the God times roll. Yes, let the God times roll. So, I'm excited. Oh, if you would like this, go to my website, www.amora.me/manifestation. Everything is my website. It's my name.me/a-lot-of-things. So manifestation, and you will have this. I believe you can download it from there. If not, I'll make another link where you can copy and paste it. But this is an everyday thing. Every day, every day, every day. Every day. Every day, all day. Man, this is a spiritual warfare we are in, my brethren. It is time to gather the armor of faith. It is time. Sorry. Sorry, guys. All right, that's it. I have to go feed my stray cat. So there's... He's been stalking me since I got here. He's a mangy old thing. And I'm, like, always trying to get him away because I don't want him to touch me because he's really, like, mangy. His tail is, like, half dead, has hair on the top and not on the bottom. He's half white and half gray, so he's in the dirt everywhere. I want him to take a bath, but he sits outside and just meows. And he just asks for food, and, like, I think he knows I'm a healer. Cats and men. I get the broken ones. No, I'm joking. I also saw a meme that said a spiritual woman will always attract a broken man or something like that. That thing is so true, but we get to choose. Thankfully, I now have a healing practice, and I don't have to date the men that I'm supposed to be working on, because I thought I was supposed to date them for a while. I was like, oh no, they were supposed to be clients. That's what that was. Okay, I'm being silly now, but I have to go feed my kitty. So I give him, there was some tuna here when I moved in, and I mean, he's a stray cat, I don't think it'll kill him. So I started giving him tuna and some shakes. He drinks my shakes with me, because I know they're filled with vitamins and minerals, and that they're healthy and okay for animals and kids. So I just make him a little shake, I water it down, and I give him a little bit of shake and a little bit of tuna he comes around here about 3 times a day. So I give it to him about 3 times a day. And I'm going to heal him, and he's going to be a nice, fluffy, pretty kitty by the time I'm done. Because right now, I just need him not to touch me. At least he don't have no pus nowhere. But okay, guys. I love you guys. Besos.